So this actually looks like we have blanching of the blood vessels down here, and this can indicate what we call sepsis, so widespread bacterial infection.
Franklin, a 23-year-old yellow-bellied slider, shows signs of a serious bacterial infection and shell rot.
Okay, I can cry. No, I didn't want to cry.
Yeah, you're good. You can cry.
There's just never been anything wrong with them.
Yeah.
Turtles don't make much noise and they can't kind of convey their pain, so it's scary.
What's your tank setup look like?
He's in a container about this big
okay. And
about that high, and he's got a little UV lamp and some shells that he goes on to bask.
Okay. Do you know what your temperature of your water is?
I don't know the exact temperature, but it's pretty warm. But recently we moved into a new house and it's a lot colder.
Okay.
And his old setup was right underneath a window with direct sunlight.
Okay.
And now it's still next to a window, but the sun doesn't hit it as much, so I'm thinking it made it a little cooler.
Reptiles, in particular, have different temperature, water quality, humidity requirements for each species. And so if they don't have that, it could definitely throw things off in their system and cause them to get sick.
He's also been doing, like, kind of gasping for air, which I've never seen.
And that may be all related to the bacterial infection. And so, you know, it may be having some pneumonia, probably due to the colder temperature of the water.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to get a heating element in there or a heating lamp as well. Obviously, we're still very active, so that's good.
Mm-hmm.
But I would recommend that we check his kidney value today, as well as start him on antibiotics and anti-inflammatories, and then we could do a shell rot treatment for these top pieces.
Okay. Does that hurt?
It can be painful. If his kidney value is normal, we'll put him on an anti-inflammatory pain med.
Okay.
Aw. Okay. He's a cute little guy. We'll take good care of him.
And it's crazy. He's 23. He doesn't look
it. He looks good for 23. Franklin's middle age, so we're gonna make sure we do a thorough physical exam on him, and then I do wanna check all his values in his body. I wanna check liver, I wanna check kidneys, and make sure everything's functional so that we can get him on medications.
So we're gonna get some blood on him.
Yes. Beautiful.
Now we're gonna treat his shell.
He has some changes on his shell that I'm worried about. Shell rot most often is from abnormal temperatures, abnormal water quality that causes either a fungal or bacterial infection that affects the keratin in the shell and can go down into the bone as well.
Oh, I took care of that one. Oh, I fixed both of them. He has retained shed, so we're taking off that retained shed right now. But he does have some of this white material here, and that's the indication of shell rot. His lesions, once we got those pieces of retained shell off, are very, very mild. Cover his eyes. Yep.
We're gonna debride the areas that we're worried about shell rot, and that makes it more porous and receptive so that we can treat it.
This is a copper tox treatment. It is like an antifungal. They use it a lot in horses for the condition thrush. And it works really well with shell rot lesions. You're gonna be a new boy.
Franklin's shell issue now resolved. Dr. Stoneberg turns her attention to treating the slider's bacterial infection.
Blood work is back on Franklin, and his kidneys are working appropriately. So this is really good news for Franklin that internally everything is working okay. And I'm gonna send him home on some pain meds and as well as some antibiotics.
All right, here he is. Look at, we made his shell all pretty. Once we got that retained shed off, there was just a couple lesions of shell rot. So right there and right there is where I debrided, okay? His kidney value is normal, so that's good news. They're getting meds filled right now.
Okay.
We need to increase the water temperature and increase his environmental temperature to help him fight this off.
Hopefully he makes a full recovery. Mom's super worried about him, but I think she's gonna make the appropriate changes for him at home and he's gonna do well.
Oh, your shell looks so nice.
I didn't even think it was possible, honestly, to find somebody who could care for someone so small, so thank you. And I feel a lot better and I'll know where to come in the future. Hopefully I don't have a reason to come, but if I do ever need to, I know where I'll go.